On January 16, 1920, the Great American Bender came to an end when the Volstead Act was signed into law and became the 18th Amendment to the Constitution. So began the Great Prohibition Era, brought on in part by a decades-old grassroots temperance campaign organized largely by women that had already succeeded in banning liquor in 25 states. Now the entire country would go dry. Everywhere, law enforcement officials set about enforcing prohibition by tracking down stills and stashes and disposing of them. Throughout the country, raids were made on bootleggers' hideouts, and cask after cask of bathtub gin were hacked open by eager police. Unfortunately, prohibition had many unintended consequences. For one thing, it divided the country between dries and wets, those who supported or opposed the 18th Amendment. For another, crime soared as people turned to bootleggers to obtain their liquor. Supplying alcohol to a thirsty populace soon became the province of organized criminal syndicates, led by some of the most notorious figures in American history. The problems with legislating morality soon became abundantly clear as underground drinking spots, speakeasies, flourished as millions of Americans evaded prohibition and continued to party like never before. The glamour of the speakeasies proved a powerful attraction, and later research showed that more people drank during the 1920s than before prohibition.